Hi, welcome to the series of video lectures on microwave engineering. Today we will discuss two cavity klystron amplifier output power and voltage gain expressions. See, as explained in the previous classes about this working of these two cavity klystron amplifier, let us revise it. See, it consists of two cavities, Bunsen cavity and a Kachin cavity. This is also called input cavity, this is also called as output cavity. The RF input which is to be amplified is applied to the Bunsen cavity, which is given as Vs is equal to V1 sin omega t, where V1 is the amplitude of the signal which is to be amplified. The operation of this two cavity klystron amplifier is very simple. When the gap voltage, this is Bunsen cavity gap, when the gap voltage is 0, the electron travels with unchanged velocity, so that is V0. During the positive half cycle of RF input voltage, the electron beam gets accelerated. During the negative half cycle, of RF input voltage across the gap, the electron beam gets decelerated. So due to this, the velocity modulation occurs. So we have derived the expression for V of T1 in the first lecture of two cavity klystron amplifier. So due to this velocity modulation, electrons are formed into bunches in the drift space. So this bunching of electron causes into current modulation, and we have also derived expression for current modulation expression, and we have to also derive delta L in the drift space where the bunching occurs, and also we have derived the optimum distance between the cavities in the previous lectures. Now see, let us see when this bunch should pass through this Kachin cavity gap. So let us see the further details of two cavity klystron amplifier. See, the first point, the maximum bunching should occur approximately midway between the Kachin cavity grids. So that is, the maximum bunching should occur approximately between the Kachin cavity grids. So that is the first point. So the second point is that the phase of the Kachin cavity gap voltage must be maintained in such a way that the bunched electrons, as they pass through the grids, encounter a retarding phase. So this is a very important point. So what is this? This bunched electron beam should pass through this Kachin cavity gap during the retarding phase. During the retarding phase means when the gap voltage is negative. So what we have to ensure that this bunched electron beam, the bunches should pass during the retarding phase of Kachin cavity gap voltage. So that we have to ensure. So what will happen? See, when the bunched electron beam passes through the retarding phase, its kinetic energy is transferred to the field of Kachin cavity. So this is how the amplification occurs. See, again I am repeating this point. When the bunched electron beam passes through the retarding phase, so that is when the bunched electron beam, passes through this retarding phase, that means retarding phase here, the gap voltage is negative. So then its kinetic energy is transferred to the field of the Kachin cavity. Then the electron bunch will transfer its kinetic energy, the electron beam will transfer its kinetic energy to the cavity gap, so that therefore the amplification of the signal occurs. So this is how the amplification of this occurs. The bunched electron beam should pass through during the retarding phase of the Kachin cavity gap. So then only the amplification of the signal occurs. So this is what we have written here. So now finally, when the electrons emerge from the Kachin cavity grids, that means when the electrons emerge from these grids, they have reduced velocity and finally collected by the collector. So therefore they have reduced velocity because they have given their energy to this cavity gap, they have given their maximum energy to this cavity gap. So therefore the velocity of these electrons gets reduced and the energy of this electron beam gets reduced, and it is finally collected by the collector. Now already we have derived that the current due to current modulation, the current at the Kachin cavity grids is a periodic waveform with a period 2π, as explained in the previous class. So since this current I2 at the Kachin cavity grids is a periodic waveform, which can be explained with the help of trigonometric Fourier series. So we have written it as the trigonometric Fourier series of I2. So what is I2? The current at the catcher cavity grids is given by the what is the trigonometric Fourier series expand summation A0 summation n is equal to 1 to infinity An cos n omega T2 plus Bn sin n omega T2. What is this? This is the current at the catcher cavity grids. So this formula is very, very important. Why? This is the periodic signal expansion. Period, any periodic signal can be expanded by using trigonometric Fourier series where minus pi less than or equal to omega 2 less than or equal to pi. So that means the period is 2 pi. So we have calculated A0. So A0 will come out as the DC beam current I0. We have to remember this. The An, the trigonometric Fourier series coefficients, An is given as formula 2I0 Jn of nx. I have derived it in the previous class. Jn of nx into cos n theta g. You have to remember this formula is very, very important. N theta 0. Similarly, in the same formula, Bn, the trigonometric Fourier series, same answer, 2I0 Jn of nx into, just replace cos by sine, sine n theta g plus n theta 0, where Jn of nx is the nth order Bessel's function, nth order Bessel's function of first kind. When substitute I0 here, An here, and Bn here, and cos A, cos B plus sin A, sin B, you have reduced finally this current at the catcher cavity grids as I2 is equal to, so see carefully, I0 plus what we have written, summation n is equal to 1 to infinity, so 2I0 Jn of nx into cos n omega t2 minus tau minus t0. So this is what we have derived. So that means the signal has DC value and first harmonic, second harmonic like that. So the periodic signal at catcher cavity grids at a DC value of I0 and fundamental harmonic and higher order harmonic. So this is further expanded into, so I2 is equal to I0 plus summation n, sorry, in fact summation, remove the summation, summation, substitute n is equal to 1 here, so it is represented 2i0 j1 of x cos of n, substitute 1 here, omega t2 minus tau minus t0, so I am expanding this, plus this is the first harmonic, substitute n is equal to 2, so 2i0 j2 of 2x into cos of 2 omega t2 minus tau minus t0 plus so on. So this formula is very, very important. Why am I explaining? So this is the fundamental component. Remember this word, fundamental component. So this factor is fundamental component, or you can also call it as first harmonic. First harmonic. So this one is the, this term is the second harmonic, third harmonic, etc. So this is the dominating component. So where this amplitude of the signal is the dominating component. So this is the DC value of current. Now, so this is the fundamental component of current. This is the fundamental component of current. Yet, at catcher cavity, this is the fundamental component of current at the catcher cavity grids. Now, this factor very, very important, remember that the fundamental component of, the fundamental component of induced current, remember this, induced, I am using induced current at catcher cavity grids. How much fundamental component of this current is induced into the catcher cavity? So that is given by here, write it as I2 induced. Remember this, this is the induced current into the catcher cavity. Simply beta 0, so beta 0 multiply with this component. So what is this component? This is the I2 I0, so J1 of X into cos n omega into T2 minus tau minus T0. So this is the fundamental component of This is the fundamental component of current induced into the catcher cavity grids. So this is the current induced, where beta zero is beam coupling coefficient of output cavity. So beta is the beam coupling coefficient of input cavity. So beta zero is the beam coupling coefficient of output cavity. So therefore, what is the amplitude? So this is the amplitude. So this is the amplitude of induced current into the cavity. So therefore, the amplitude or magnitude, whatever you can write, the amplitude of induced current into the catcher cavity gap is, so remember this, so this is written as capital I2 induced. What is the amplitude of current induced into the cavity? This is the amplitude of current induced into the cavity. So therefore, so what we write it as beta zero 2I0, so J1 of X. So represent this as I2. So this is further written as beta 0 into I2. So this is the, remember that. So this is the beta 0 into I2 is the induced current. So this factor is very, very important. This is the induced current into the cavity. Now, so this formula is very, very important. Remember. So this is the induced current into the cavity, where I2 is given by this formula. I2 is given by this formula. Now, draw the equivalent circuit. So therefore, the equivalent circuit of, so output cavity is written as a catcher cavity. This is RSHO. So this is written as RB. So this is written as RL. So this is the beta 0 into I2 is the induced current into the cavity. So this is the equivalent circuit of output cavity. So this is, so where RSHO is equal to resistance of catcher cavity walls. Remember that catcher cavity walls. And RB is equal to beam loading resistance. Remember this. This is beam loading resistance. Remember these words. And RL is equal to external load resistance that is connected. External load resistance that is connected to this output cavity. So therefore, this is further written as the equivalent circuit. If you reduce all this into one component, so therefore it is written as beta 0 into I2. So remember this, what is this? This is the induced current. If you parallel this, all this, you get one answer. So they represent it as RSH. So our final combined resistance of this is RSH, where RSH is equal to effective, remember these words, effective shunt resistance. Now we will define what is the power. We will derive two expressions now. The power, output power. So what is the output power? So the output power is equal to, let us call this as voltage as, remember this, the output voltage is written as VTU. So what is beta 0 into I2 is the peak value in this formula. Peak value convert into RMS value, so that is peak value by root 2. What is output power? So beta 0 into I2 by root 2 whole square. So root 2 will come out as 2 into RSH. Simple formula. So convert into RMS value, beta 0 I2 by root 2 whole square, I square R formula. So RSH. So this further simplify it as, so beta 0 into I2, write one term. So beta 0 I2 into RSH, write one more term. So this is 2. But beta 0 I2 into RSH is nothing but as V2. So this is written as, so beta 0 I2 V2 by 2. So this is the output power. So this is the output power. Remember, important formula, output power. Now, what is the input power? The input power is, the input power P in is equal to V0 into cathode voltage into DC beam current. So what is the efficiency? The efficiency of two cavity crystalline amplifier is, efficiency of two cavity crystalline amplifier is equal to P out by P in, so which is given by 2, sorry, in fact, beta 0 I2 V2 by 2 V0 I0. So we, this formula is also very, very important. We use this formula while solving the problems. So this is the efficiency of two cavity crystalline amplifier. The efficiency is in between, the efficiency is about 15 to 30% for two cavity practical amplifier. Practical two cavity crystalline amplifiers, the efficiency is around 15 to 30%. Now let us define another parameter, which is called as mutual conductance of two cavity klystron amplifier. Another very, very important parameter, mutual conductance of two cavity klystron amplifier. Mutual conductance of two cavity klystron amplifier. So it is represented with GM. It is defined as the ratio of induced current into the catcher cavity by the input voltage V1. So this is the formula for mutual conductance. M stands for mutual conductance of amplifier. Two cavity crystalline conductance is induced current into the catcher cavity, amplitude of induced current into the catcher cavity by input signal which is to be amplified. Now let us derive this formula. So this is given by GM is equal to, what is the induced current into the beta 0 into I2 by V1. Again, what is beta 0 into, what is I2? 2 I0 into, so J1 of X by V1. So but from bunching parameter, as you know the formula, very, very important formula, the bunching parameter X is equal to beta I V1 by 2V0 into beta I V1 by 2V0 into theta 0. Now see V1, so take V1 here from this formula. So 2V0x by, so beta I into theta 0, substitute this value here in this formula, so therefore the mutual transconductance is given by, so beta 0 into, so 2I0 into, so J1 of X by, so what is V1 here from this formula? So 2V0x beta I into theta 0. So this is further written as, the mutual conductance is written as, if the input cavity beam coupling coefficient and output beam coupling coefficients are equal, so that is if beta I is equal to beta 0, this is written as beta 0 square, 2 gets cancels out. So this is written as, so G0 written as beta 0 square, so J1 of X by X, so beta 0 square, so J1 of X by X into theta 0. So this is the mutual normalized mutual conductance. So what is this? Is normalized mutual conductance. Normalized mutual conductance. Normalized mutual conductance. So where G0 is equal to I0 by V0 is DC beam conductance. DC beam conductance. We use this formula. Finally, we derive the voltage gain, last one. So voltage gain, what is the voltage gain of the amplifier? Simple formula, V2 by V1. So the output voltage by input voltage is the voltage gain. So what is V2? So V2 is the beta 0 from this formula, beta 0 into I2 into RSS, which I have given. So by V1. So from this, remember carefully, V0, beta 0 into what is I2? So 2I0, so J1 of X by V1 into RSH, that is effective shunt resistance. Substitute V1 from this formula into this. So therefore the voltage gain of the amplifier will come out as, the voltage gain of the amplifier will come out as beta 0 square theta 0 by R0 into J1 of X by X into RSH. So this is the very, very important formula of voltage gain. Remember this formula we use further use in while solving the problems. So this is the voltage gain of two cavity klystron amplifier. So where R0 is equal to V0 by I0, DC beam resistance, whereas I0 by V0 is the DC beam conductance, R0 is equal to V0 by I0, DC beam conductance. So this is what about the voltage gain, very, very important formula while we solve the problems. So this is the efficiency of two cavity klystron amplifier. So this is finally what we have to write about this output power we have derived, the voltage gain of the amplifier we have derived. So this is all about the mathematical analysis of two cavity klystron amplifier.